Alhaj Muhammad Badaru Abu Bakr, the Jigawa State Governor, in the last 2 years continued to lead the state to its glorious future. The impacts of governance is being felt across all sectors and strata of the Jigawa society, despite the burden of financial obligations inherited from the previous administration and the declining fiscal resources accruable to the state. Indeed, the progress recorded so far in all the sectors has indicated that with ingenuity and innovative approach to governance, hopes can be restored, dreams achieved, and challenges transformed to opportunities. As at 29th May 2015, the volume of liabilities and ongoing capital projects was at the time more than the entire annual budget of the state, which was 100 billion naira. Ironically, the state's financial liquidity position stood at just 16 million naira. The state was burdened with a lot of other challenges, which could have crippled the operations of government if not properly managed. This includes declining fiscal resources, high cost of governance, unsustainable salary bills, and inefficiencies in resource management. But the governor, being a trained accountant who understands that governance is public trust, quickly adopted the prudence and value for money principle. Through these measures, the cost of governance and service delivery has been drastically reduced, while at the same time expanding the scope and quality of public service. Standing orders on government spending has been reduced by 27%. Also, government house expenditure has been reduced by 68%. Expenses of the Deputy Governor's office reduced by 46%, security and related expenses reduced by 91%, protocol expenses reduced by 81%, while overhead has been reduced by 54%. Even with the massive decline in financial resources available to government, it has not failed in its responsibility of discharging its financial obligations. Salaries and allowances are being paid as at when due. In addition, capital investments have also been made in critical sectors. Governor Muhammad Badaru, in trying to tackle the ugly menace of poverty that has been ravaging the state for a long time, quickly rolled out a series of empowerment interventions for the youthful population, and also constituted a committee on empowerment with a clear mandate to embark on community consultations on their needs and priority traits, and come up with various economic empowerment programs that are demand-driven and efficient. A total 50,140 people have benefited from the various empowerment programs in the last 2 years. 15,000 farmers have been empowered with quality input under the Outgrower Scheme, while thousands of other youths have been empowered in the various cluster farming and seed development programs and agricultural value chain across the state. 5,740 widows were empowered with 17,220 goats in the state goat breeding microcredit scheme. Hundreds of youths were also trained and given seed capital to start businesses in areas of scrap dealing, welding, apiculture, fish farming, poultry, to mention but a few. To create an alternative economy, the governor put in place aggressive measures to revamp the agricultural sector in the state and reposition farming as a profitable venture. Through initiatives like the cluster farming program, farmers now have access to quality input, extension services, harvest support, and much more. The cluster farms are designed to solve the problems of small farm holding inherent in Jigawa and other African farming communities. With this scheme, farmers are now assured of higher productivity and competitiveness. The cluster farming initiative reflects the steps being taken by Jigawa State to attain the Sustainable Development Goals through improvements in sustainable small-scale agricultural development, focusing on precision quality, input provision to poor farmers, and targeted extension service to attain huge improvements in yield. So far, 15,097 farmers have been engaged in the cultivation of rice, groundnuts, sesame, and soybeans across a farmland of 12,115 hectares across the state. With more than 70% repayment rate at harvest time, the program has been deemed successful and is now being extended to cover more hectares. From a productivity basis, the focused approach adopted for the cluster initiative has not only expanded the amount of land brought under cultivation, it has also positively impacted on yield across the board. For instance, the average yield of rice has improved from 2.4 tons per hectare to an average of 5.1 tons per hectare, with some sites recording as much as 8 tons per hectare. The same can be said for groundnut, soybeans, and wheat. In general, about 40,000 farmers have benefited from the various agricultural interventions. The present administration understands the importance of providing qualitative infrastructure and swung into action immediately after assuming office. 39 road projects measuring 698 kilometers inherited from the previous administration and connecting critical towns and villages across the state are now at various stages of completion. This consists of 481 of regional. This consists of 481 kilometers of regional roads, 94 kilometers of feeder roads, and 119 kilometers of township roads. In line with the administration principle of financial discipline, the governor Muhammad Badaru-led government renegotiated the contract sum with the contractors and realized a discount of 8.2 billion naira on all the road contracts. In addition to the execution of inherited road projects, the Governor Muhammad Badaru-led administration has awarded contracts for the construction of 30 new road projects, bridge and culverts with total length of 347 kilometers. In a nutshell, the Jigawa State Government is at present constructing over 1,000 kilometers of roads across the state. To make sure people have access to clean and safe water, the governor embarked on the rehabilitation of township water schemes, construction of solar-powered water schemes, installation of hand pumps and motorized water schemes, as well as the construction of VIP pit latrines at strategic locations across the state. This includes the rehabilitation of 108 motorized water supply schemes on the Jigawa State Water Board, 240 solar and motorized water supply schemes under STOA, 4,571 hand pump operated boreholes under RUWASA. In all, 3.5 billion naira has been spent on the rehabilitation of township water schemes, while the sum of 1.6 billion naira was incurred on the maintenance of generators, procurement of diesel and water treatment chemicals. The government of Alhaji Muhammad Abubakar inherited a health sector plagued with poor indices as well as decaying infrastructure. despite efforts by the previous administrations to reposition the sector. The sectoral policies were to a large extent not aligned with federal government policies, as a system called Gunduma Health System was the operational framework of the sector as against primary health care obtained all over the country. The system was characterized by inadequate human resources for health, exemplified by doctor-patient ratio. To address these problems, the state government immediately declared an emergency in the sector. Primary Health Care Agency replaced the Gunduma system, aligning the existing system with the national health policy. Establishment of local government area primary health care in the 27 local government areas and the reposition of the Ministry of Health to align with scheme of service. To ensure that the manpower is strengthened in all the health facilities, the cleansing of the payroll system ensured that a total of 54 million naira was saved on a monthly basis, with improved service delivery among personnel of the various health centers in the state. Savings from the cleansing ensured that 450 primary healthcare workers were recruited and 119 midwives, as well as 65 CHEWs absorbed from the MSS and SHAW-P midwives by the state. To ensure that the manpower is strengthened in all the health facilities, the government absorbed 15 medical officers post NYSC, 30 house officers, 3 radiographers, 5 medical lab scientists, 107 nurses, November 2015 and 2016 sets from School of Nursing Benin Kudu into the payroll in line with the bonding policy of the state. Government has engaged 35 senior doctors to provide specialist care across the state. 28 medical doctors are currently training as consultants in various teaching hospitals across the country. 60 students have been sent to study medicine in China. Upon graduation, they will be posted to hard-to-reach health facilities in the state. Government established School of Nursing and Midwifery in Hadejia and facilitated the license to establish a School of Midwifery in Birnin Kudu. In addressing the infrastructural deficit at the secondary health centers, a number of interventions have been undertaken, especially in the construction and rehabilitation of health facilities. The primary healthcare subsector also witnessed the renovation of Majiri, Kununu and Kasinawa health clinics, as well as Sarawa health post. 25 health facilities in Birnin Kudu, Garki, Gwaram, Guri, Jahun and Maigatari local government areas were renovated in partnership with MNCH2. There has been tremendous increase in health interventions across the state, with thousands of patients benefiting from free surgeries and health care services. 2 years of this administration, remarkable achievement was recorded in cross-border trade with the Republic of Niger. Indeed, the launching and implementation of the Zindir Daura Jigawa Kano Trade Corridor has opened a new chapter in the participation of the populace in international trade. The solid mineral sector is in the process of being formalized in the state, with the baseline survey and subsequent registration of 50 cooperative groups of miners across 13 local governments. Utilizing its acquired license, the state government entered into an agreement with MESSRSGCC Vanguard Limited for the establishment of a granite tiles production company at Kachi in Duse local government area of the state. The state government was also successful in the acquisition of licenses for the exploration of copper, gold and clay. The aggressive investment promotion efforts of the state is beginning to yield the desired benefits. So far, the state maintains an investment pipeline of approximately $1 billion from 30 active investments spread across agriculture, renewable energy, hospitality, education, and manufacturing. Notable among these investments are the Vinilan Footwear Factory in Kijawal, which has already commenced production, providing jobs for 200 people with future prospects of employing 1,500 at optimum capacity. Dangote Rice, which is expanding its outgrower scheme project in Hago, Fadama, as part of its 300,000 tons per annum rice mill in the state. Northern Agribusiness Limited, a 100,000 tons per annum sugar factory in Gagarawa. Erisco Foods Limited, a tomato production and processing plant. Pan Africa Solar Group, Nova Scotia Power Development Company, and Oriental Renewable Energy Limited, solar power generation plants with a combined capacity of 250 megawatts. Lahoms Limited, constructing about 500 housing units in Duzi. Three Brothers Rice Mill and Klysat Foods, rice mills with combined capacity of 80,000 tons, among many others. On assumption of office in 2015, the government realized that the education sector is in a state of near collapse. Governor Muhammad Badaru immediately embarked on statewide consultations with stakeholders in this sector. The painstaking exercise led to the formulation of the Education Change Agenda. The agenda encompasses a holistic approach targeted at solving the identified challenges in the sector with a strong focus on primary education. To tackle the infrastructural challenges bedeviling the education sector at the basic level, Governor embarked on the construction and renovation of 3,557 classrooms, 50 toilet blocks, 6 admin blocks, supply of 60,643 sets of pupils and students' furniture, and 3,225 sets for teachers, and 36 hand pumps, 96 houses, and 4 hostels. At the senior secondary level, the ministry has awarded contracts for the construction and renovation of school structures at GGSS Sultan Karkar, GSS Malam Madori, GSS Aujara, GSS Kazaure, GGASS Baora, and GGASS Danzomo. Efforts are in top gear to fill the gap of 6,000 teachers at the basic level, as well as 2,000 at the senior secondary level. Two primary schools and one junior secondary school in hard-to-reach areas in each of the 287 political wards are being converted to special schools with the complement of standard classrooms and qualified teachers. The schools are being constructed alongside 4 residential houses to serve as living quarters for teachers handling core subjects. The idea is to ensure equal access to qualitative education, regardless of location. The investments in the education sector have started yielding positive results. The state recorded 16.84% success in the 2016 WAEC results, as against 4.59% in 2015 and 4.88% in 2014. The same success was recorded in the NECO exams with a 50.2% performance in 2016 as against 38.9% in 2015 and 38.14% in 2014. The performance of the state in WAEC and NECO examinations is an indication that given the right leadership, the impossible can be made possible and the unsurpassable can be surpassed. In the tertiary education, Renovations and new infrastructures were put in place in Sulalamido University, Kafin Hausa, Binyamin Usman Polytechnic, Hadeja, and College of Islamic and Legal Studies, Ringim. At inception of this administration, it was discovered that the state was faced with some of the most devastating environmental challenges, such as desertification, typha and aquatic weeds invasion, massive flood and erosion, as well as poor waste management. In order to reduce the adverse effects of desert encroachment and its attendant consequences, the state government raised and distributed 5 million assorted and indigenous tree seedlings. During the World Desertification Day celebrations, which was hosted in the state in 2016, His Excellency directed that 11 trees should be planted during any public occasion in the state. That has since become a tradition. To control aquatic weeds invasion and enhance free flow of water along the course of River Hadeja, the ministry, in collaboration with Hadeja Jama'ari River Basin Development Authority, engaged a machine for typha grass clearance downstream for Burum Gana in Guri local government area, a distance of 15 kilometers, was cleared. Government also facilitated manual river channels clearance by identifying and supporting 15 self-help organizations along River Hadeja, covering 13 local government areas, namely Ringim, Taura, Jahun, Miga, Kaugama, Kafin Hausa, Auyo, Hadeja, Malam Madori, Kirikasamma, Guri, Birniwa, and Gwaram.